Guys, I got an Olivia Rodrigo ticket. I'm so excited! I'm going to see Olivia Rodrigo live in concert on the 8th of May. I am light as a feather, I'm as stiff as a board. Like the teenage angstiness. And guys, I'm just a 21-year-old teenage girl, okay? So I just really relate to her anger at the world, and I can't wait to sing all about her life. Obviously, the demand for tickets was very, very high, so we had to register for ticket sale, and then a select few people were sent a special link to shop the tickets on Tuesday, I think it was, and then the rest of us were waitlisted. I'm sure anyone who's tried to get tickets knows, because I imagine the process is the same everywhere. But I was waitlisted, I was soul destroyed, I was being really melodramatic. I was like to my mom, like, I'm just like so sick of, like, I just feel like I don't have anything to look forward to, and like this would have been like a really nice thing to look forward to. And she was like, I mean, it's a concert. And I was like, yeah, but mom, like, Olivia Rodrigo's my girl. So anyway, I was sad, and then the general sale, like, there was tickets left over, so they put general sale on today. And I was like, I don't want to get my hopes up, okay? I don't want to get my hopes up, because again, the demand is so high, there simply isn't enough tickets for everyone who wants to go. But I was like, I'll give it my best go. I was in the middle of getting my nails done, we'll talk about that in a second. And I was like to my auntie, we need to stop. I need to join this ticket queue, because this needs to happen. And she was like, okay, girl, do your thing. So I got my ticket. Was it £140? Yeah. And it's not even a standing ticket. But I got it. I've always had like a pretty varied music taste, but the last like maybe 6 months I've been in my fucking pop princess era. I hate that term, era. But I've been in my pop princess bag. I can't get enough. Sabrina Carpenter, Tate McRae, Olivia Rodrigo, Nessa Barrett, my girls. Miley has also always been my girl, but like I'm talking like the young up and comers who are like my age. I fuck with them so hard. Madison Beer, missed one. God, I love them. And this week has been a phenomenal week because, well, last week and this week, Olivia Rodrigo dropped her new album. Madison Beer dropped her new album. Season 4 of Sex Education came out today. And best of all, season 4 of Call Her Daddy started on Wednesday. And then Alex Earle's podcast, Hot Mess, had its first episode yesterday, which was Thursday. Today is Friday. And then on Monday, Madeline Argy's first episode of Pretty Lonesome is coming out. It's just too much. There's too much good shit happening. I actually can't believe it. This is a great time to be alive. September 2023 is going down as the best month in my life so far, solely because of these things that have all happened. Because let me tell you, I've been hating my job more than I've ever hated my job in my life this month. But all these great things are coming out that I'm loving. I love the gym. I love getting my nails done. Like, it's just the little things, even though work is absolutely dreadful. We don't want to talk about work. It's the weekend. I get Fridays and Saturdays off. So this morning I went to the gym, went to the shops, as always, literally same shit, different day. Like, I live, my life is like Groundhog Day. Like, every day's the same. But anyway, got my nails done. Whoa, what am I doing? How am I, hello? What the hell am I doing? I'm trying to, okay. They're like a matcha green, which is different for me not something I'd usually go for. I prefer a girly nail. I love a pink, or I love a red, or if I'm getting like a blue or something, I really like to have it sparkly. But today I just decided to go for a little basic matcha green vibe. And they're short too, because these are my own nails, and I usually like to have them longer than this, but my thumb and then I think it was this finger had kind of split a little bit, so we had to bring them down, which is a real shame. So I'm not quite feeling like myself with these green mid-length nails, but it's fine because in 2 weeks time I can get them pink and long again, because they will have grown by then. I'm about to head to my laser hair removal appointment, and I also wanted to chat about laser and my experience, because I'm going to take you along for a little like BTS of my laser. My experience with laser. I started laser, I think like January of 2023, and we're now in September. I booked a block of 10, and so far I've had 8 of my 10 sessions. Now, laser is different for everyone. For some people it works like miracles, and for other people it simply doesn't really work. And unfortunately, it's not really working for me. It's not really working for me. Like I said, I've had 8 out of 10 sessions, so I can't like comment yet, because by the end of my 10th session, like maybe we'll see a change. They do say that like one block is what they recommend, but I'm thinking I might have to get a second block and just hope that it works after the second block. I don't know. But I've seen absolutely no change, not even the smallest change in my hair growth. Yeah, I can't speak for everyone, but for me, laser hasn't worked, has not been worth it. But I have spoken to other people who have a different experience, so, you know, that's just me. In terms of pain, guys, the first session I was like, this is so easy. Like, I feel nothing. And then session 2 onwards, like, I have a high pain tolerance, okay? When it comes to things like waxing, I'm totally fine, can handle that just fine. Ear piercings, fine. Giving blood, fine. Like any other kind of needle stuff, fine. Laser, fucking hell. It's so bad. It is, and it's short-lived, right? Like it doesn't last long, and it's every 6 weeks, so it's not that dramatic. But holy fucking shitballs. Oh, I'm like sweating, like trying to suppress like squeals, like it is bad. But again, that's different for everyone. It doesn't hurt everyone, so don't let me freak you out. Not everyone has like a painful laser experience, but my laser experience is less than ideal. Anyway, we're gonna go to laser and you're coming with me, so put your shoes on and let's go. You will need a jacket because it's quite cold. Good morning, friends. It's Saturday and I figured for funsies, why don't I give you a quick room tour just while we're here. So we come in the door. I'm just about to hoover. The carpet needs hoovered. It's all, I like it to be lined. So every time I walk all over it, I have to get the hoover and make the lines again. You come in the door. The first thing you see is my bed. Now, I used to be a gal who liked like colorful, bright bedding, and now it has to be all white bedding. It just has to be. I'm not very good at making my bed. I make it every day, but not really properly. I just like to have it, you know, semi-made. And then always have a fluffy blanket on my bed all through the winter, all through the spring, autumn, summer, every season, because even in summer in Scotland, it does not get very warm. And then this is Meredith. She's a jelly cat. My mum bought her for me in London, and she's called Meredith because Meredith's my like comfort character from Grey's Anatomy, so she's called Mer. And then we have this big tall window, and then over here we have my floor length mirror. This unit, now this unit when we bought it was like normal wood colour, like brown. And then I painted it dark grey for my bedroom upstairs, because upstairs I had a dark grey carpet. I've now moved downstairs to a different bedroom. And then I bought white paint and tried to paint these myself white. And my mum wouldn't help me because she was like, no, it's the principal, Dana. Like, you need to learn to do these things yourself. And she's right, but I got bored. So I did one layer and then left it. And it looks like shit. And then I got these cute little
I changed all the little knobs. Got these cute ones from TK Maxx. And these ones. Here we have, these are my Holy Grail perfumes, my all-time favorites. So we have Alien by Mugler, Alien Goddess by Mugler, Bear by Victoria's Secret, Daisy Love by Marc Jacobs, and J'adore by Dior. This is a picture of Georgia Smith. My best friend from high school is an incredible artist, and she painted this for me because Georgia Smith is one of my all-time favorite artists, and we were both obsessed with her, so she painted me this, and it was so, so, so lovely of her. And then we have these two little fake plants. I can't do real plants. I don't really have the energy to keep them alive. I barely have the energy to keep myself alive. Thank you. And then again, my friend from high school, the same one who did the Georgia Smith painting, she painted this cute little pot for me, with boobs and butts and all the cool girly stuff. And then this is my little jewelry holder. It's from Amazon. So we have these little two ring holders and this ring holder also from Amazon. This arm cuff is from Depop. This arm cuff is from a little local shop in Greece. And then we just have some necklaces all here. And then I love this section. This is my New York corner. So I just have some of my favorite pictures of New York so that when I'm not there, I can pretend I am. I love New York so much. Okay, then here we have my favorite part of my room. So this is my little bookshelf. So we have Captivate by Claudia Schiffer here. And then we have all these books. So we have Dior, Vivienne Westwood, Versace, Louis Vuitton, and Chanel. I love these books. They're gorgeous. These all obviously don't match. Like, I know most people will get one that like matches their aesthetic, but I just wanted them all. And my room doesn't really have a color scheme as such. So they're just all chilling together. Okay, and then here is my bookshelf. So these are all my unread books. My read books live in the garage or they get donated, but this is all my unread books. So the top shelf is hardback fiction, and then I just have my productivity method planner here to hold these books up because they kept falling. And then this is my paperback fiction. And then this is all non-fiction. And then we have my wardrobe, and on my wardrobe I keep these cute little quotes. So we have, I'm creating the life of my dreams, I'm stepping into the most successful decade of my life, a new era of me, good things are coming, and my soul seeks growth, and then be ready, big changes are coming. So this is my wardrobe. It has a mirror on this side. Hi me! Inside the wardrobe, we have this little organizer thing from IKEA. So up the top there, we have belts, fluffy socks, and tights. Then the next one down is bras and bralettes. Then the next one down is comfy pants. Then we have normal socks. Then we have like high socks, as I call them, like the socks that you pull up over the bottoms of your leggings. And then we have poofas, the little things that you scrub yourself with in the shower. And then on my thongs, because these pants only get worn like if I'm at home, because who needs pant lines? So I keep them separately so they're easy to find. And then we just have some of my clothes hanging here. So these are all my nice dresses and stuff. And then these are lingerie bags. Then in here, we just have, what do we even have in here? I think this is like matching sets. So like my little Tala set in here, got some lounge sets in here, but just like everyday underwear matching sets. Then in here is all my bikinis. And then in here we have pads, tampons, and a sticky bra, just girly things. And then this little bit for some jewelry. So we have Monica Vinader, Heaven Mayhem, Drizzy Daze. These are just earrings, some claw clips, anklets, Vivienne Westwood, Sabi, Millie Grace, Sorority, Monica Vinader, Jesmyn Holmes. These cute little earrings. And here's hoodies and stuff, color coordinated. And then this is all my activewear. And then this is more lingerie boxes in here. And then under my bed, I have these baskets with all my toiletries. I'm like obsessed with toiletries. I'm scared that I'm going to run out of them. And therefore, I buy them in excess. And every birthday and Christmas, my mum like restocks all my toiletries for me as part of my gift. So this is all shampoos, conditioners, body lotions, body scrubs, and then there's a hair mask there at the back. And then this one is body washes, mouthwash, cotton pads, razors. And this one is like face wash, retinol, sun cream, and lip balm. All in here.
Look at the doggies. What is it, Bella?
Bella! Come on, man.
Hello, everyone. I was just editing the vlog and I'm about to finish it, but first I wanted to show you what I'm reading right now. I just finished a book yesterday called Happy Place by Emily Henry and I loved it. I would probably rate it 9 out of 10. I really, really, really liked it a lot. One of the best books I've read this year, if not the best. Possibly the best. I loved it. And I'm going to read all the rest of her books now. And she's officially one of my favourite authors, I have decided. But currently, I am reading The List by Yomi Adeguke. I am only 2 chapters in, so I can't really give you like a review, but I like it so far. I will read you blurb because it's a very interesting plot line. Ola, a high-profile journalist at Woman magazine, is marrying the love of her life in 1 month's time. Young, beautiful, and successful, she and her fiancé Michael are the couple of goals of their social networks. And as Michael has finally landed the job of his dreams, the pair truly seem to have it all. Until one morning when they both wake up to the same message. Oh my god, have you seen the list? It began as a list of anonymous allegations about abusive men circulated in secret to protect other women. Now it has been published online. Ola made her name breaking exactly this type of story. She would usually be the first to cover it, calling for the men to be fired. Except today, Michael's name is on there. With their future on the line, Ola gives Michael an ultimatum to prove his innocence by their wedding day. But will the truth of what happened change everything for both of them? Very of the times, you know? So I'm very excited to get further into this. But anyways, thank you for watching and I'll see you in my next one. I'm so sleepy. So sleepy.